See, next concept which we need to understand in order to find out the consumer equilibrium in the case of ordinal analysis is your budget line. In the previous video, we have started the indifference curve. In this video, we will be understanding the budget line. So, in the case we have started indifference set, so the same we will be starting the budget set. Now, see, what is the budget set? Budget set refers to the set of possible combinations of the only two commodities. The consumer can buy from his given income. See, if you do not have purchasing power, how will you be able to buy the commodity, right? So you have a fixed income, 20,000. From that you bifurcate your expenses. How do you do so? How you find out that I have to buy oranges more or apple more, and you just have to spend rupees 200 from that income. So from 200, how many oranges or apples you can buy? The various sets, like you can buy 10 oranges, 2 apples, then you can buy 8 oranges and 3 apples, and you can buy 6 oranges, 4 apples. So how different combinations you can buy from your given income of 200? This is given by your budget set. At this point of time, your total expenditure remains the same. So your price of X is given into the quantity of X you buy, plus the price of Y is given into with the quantity of Y you buy, is equal to your total expenditure or the amount of money you have with you in order to spend on the two commodities. Now, what is your budget line? See, the budget line is your graphical representation of the budget sets that from your budget you can buy 10 oranges, 2 apples, 8 oranges, 3 apples, 6 oranges, 4 apples. So plotting these combinations on the graph gives you the budget line. This is your budget line. Right? So the market rate of exchange that will be starting in our coming video affects your budget line. Right? So if the price, let's say income is 50, your price of X is rupees 10 per unit and the price of Y is equal to rupees 5 per unit. So what does this say? Your 2Y will be equal to the price of X, right? 2 into 5, 10 is equal to 10. So what does this say is, for one extra commodity of X, you have to sacrifice 2 units of Y, right? So this is the market rate of exchange. That will be starting in our next video. But this is the budget line. On this budget, this is a straight line. On this budget line, the various sets you have, the various combinations you get, gives you the same level of satisfaction, and according to the income or the purchasing power or what you can afford, right? So this is your budget line. The formula to calculate the slope of budget line is, slope of budget line is equal to quantity of the good sacrificed. How many quantities you sacrifice for your one good for the quantity of the good obtained. This is the first formula. The second formula you can get the slope is from price of the good obtained, that was say X, that was of rupees 10, and the price of the good sacrificed. So these are the two methods to calculate the slope of budget line. There are various factors that affects the shift in the budget line. Number one, suppose your income changes. See, if your income changes, if this was your initial budget line, good X, good Y, this was the initial budget line, let's say this was your initial budget line B, AB, right? Income has increased, so your budget line will shift forward because your income has increased. You can buy more of Y and more of good X, so your budget line will become, suppose your income decreases, so your budget line will shift downwards, A to B 2. So this is the shift in your budget line due to your change in income. Now let's suppose the price of your X changes and the price of the Y remains constant and your income remains constant. This is X, O, Y. This is good X and this is good Y. And this was your initial budget line AB. Now what has happened? Your price of X has changed. Let's suppose your price of X decreases. So you will increase the consumption of X because your price decreases due to the law of demand. Suppose your price increases, what will you do? You will reduce the consumption of X. B2. That is the effect of change of price of X on your budget lines. Now, if the price of Y changes, what will happen? If the price of Y reduces, price of Y falls, what you will do? You will increase the consumption of Y. So, B will be the same and you will increase the consumption of Y. And if the price falls, you will decrease the consumption of Y. This is again the shift in your budget line. See, when more than one of the determinants changes, previously the only income was changing and then only price of X and then only price of Y, the other two of them were constant. Now in this part we will learn when more than one determinant changes. So when both price of x and price of y changes same percent and in the same direction, if the price of x is increased, the price of y is also increased. If the price of x is increased by 10%, the price of y has also increased by 10%. If the price of x has fallen down, the price of y has also fallen down. 10% has fallen down and 10% has fallen down. So what will be the change in the budget line? The budget line will shift upwards in the case of fault. See, in this case, your budget line will shift upwards. This is because the prices have fallen down. So your new budget line is good y, good x. Now, if your price of x and y have increased, so what you will do? You will reduce the consumption. So your budget line will shift downwards in the case of this, right? So this is the both the determinants have changed. When income and price of x and y changes in the same percent, let's say your income has increased by 10%. The price of X is also increased by 10%. And the price of Y have also increased by 10%. In this case, there will be no change in the budget line. The budget line will be the same as it was before. Because if the prices of X and Y have increased, your income is also increased by 10%. Right? So there will be no change in your budget line. This is when your price of X falls and the price of Y rises. See, this is your graph. This is your initial budget line, A and B. Good X, good Y. Fine. Now, how it will be effective if your price of good X has reduced? So what will you do? You will increase the consumption of good X and the price of Y has increased. So what will you do? You will reduce the consumption of Y. So this will be your new budget line. Now, if your price of X rises and the price of Y falls, what will you do? The price of X, before it was here, the price of X has increased. You will reduce its consumption, let's say here. And the price of Y have fallen down, so you will increase its consumption. So this will be your new budget line. Make sure your budget lines are in a straight manner. Just because of the improper, graphs, I'm not able to make it in the straight line. Use pencil and scale, you will get your budget lines a straight line. So with this, we complete the budget line. I hope you liked the video. Do download our Scholars Learning app and enjoy the learning experience.